What can we learn about Ludwig van Beethoven from his hair? People have studied his music, his letters, the conversation books he used to communicate as his hearing deteriorated. We also have the words of his friends, colleagues, and even his doctors. But now, for the first time, we've been able to investigate his genome. By the 1820s, Beethoven was so revered that several friends and admirers sought locks of his hair. And when he died in 1827, more locks were quickly cut from his head. Working with an international team of scientists, I identified five genetically matching, authentic locks of hair and used them to sequence Beethoven's genome. We wanted to know more about Beethoven's much-debated health problems, and we made some breakthroughs. We cannot say definitely what killed Beethoven, but we discovered significant genetic risk factors for liver disease and evidence that Beethoven contracted hepatitis B virus in, at the latest, the months before his final illness. This infection might have driven the composer's severe liver disease, exacerbated by his genetic risk and possibly his alcohol intake. But we need to be careful not to jump to conclusions. We can't be sure about the precise nature of this relationship, partly because the contemporary accounts of his alcohol consumption vary. While we couldn't pinpoint the cause of Beethoven's deafness or gastrointestinal problems, we did find modest genetic risk for systemic lupus erythematosus. We eliminated, or made less likely, several potential heritable causes for Beethoven's liver disease and bowel complaints. We also found that two of the Beethoven locks in the collections today are not authentic, including the famous lock once believed to have been cut from the dead composer's head by the 15-year-old musician Ferdinand Hiller. We now know this hair actually came from a woman. We were surprised to uncover a family mystery that shows that Beethoven wasn't actually descended, genetically, from the main Flemish Beethoven lineage. A combination of genetic and archival evidence shows that an extramarital relationship resulted in the birth of a child in Beethoven's direct paternal line at some point between 1572 and 1770, but we don't know in which generation this might have been. We hope that by making Beethoven's genome publicly available for researchers, and in due course perhaps adding further authenticated locks to this initial chronological series, remaining questions about his health and family history can someday be answered.
I'm Dr. Robert Attenborough. I'm a bioanthropologist and I've been Tristan's PhD supervisor at the University of Cambridge, along with Dr. Thomas Kivisilt, formerly of Cambridge and now at KU Leuven. This project began over 8 years ago, and Tristan has been on a remarkable journey with his numerous research partners in Europe and the United States, including Dr. William Meredith of San Jose State University and Dr. Johannes Krauser of the Max Planck Institute, Leipzig. Scholars and admirers of Beethoven will find much to think about and discuss in these findings, and hopefully they will help us to find out even more about this remarkable individual. At the same time, the extremely impressive genetic research conducted by Tristan and his colleagues will also help to inform a wide range of other projects, including research into health and genetic variation at the level of individual biography.